The title of this is You Mad. You mad, white man's interstate paved over your great-great-grandpappy's grave, huh? Your African ancestors braved the diseased, plagued bowels of a slave ship for you to rot in the bowels of a project. You still ain't human, you property, an object. Raised on cartoons and corn syrup, called Fendon, played outside too long when white man and black van was plotting your demise, pressing the exhaust, and the hood is a gas chamber your people caught in. As the money falling out your family's wallet builds more jails to keep your people barred in, you mad. Reflecting on back when them drug boys robbed that delicatessen, ran back to the block and sold your mama Robitussin to rock you back to sleep on nights. Mama kept fussing with your father, cause that nigga was too bitch to be husband, but dog enough to tuck his tail and get married to hustling. You mad?
Come on.
At your father, who'd rather raise a gang of drug boys on the corner, who sprout up like roses to get chopped by choppers and escorted to the coroner. Or who slang to suckers like your mother, who dropped you off at your aunt and uncle so you wouldn't see her in the street strung out struggling. You mad at your aunt and uncles, whose lullabies couldn't rock you back to sleep on nights gun barrels kept cussing too loud. Pow, pow, pow. Whole block stop, dropped and rolled to the ground. Same way fire hoses baptized niggas in the south. You mad because now instead of water, innocent sons and daughters with no armor getting sprayed with bullets. And we all know it was a nigga's finger who pulled it. And the black boys' doctors forgot to diagnose as doomed kids harder than to niggas who only listen to AK, K, 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 killer nigga music. You mad. You too broke down to move quick, looking out the window wishing you could scribe a new script. But you sit watching black boys act in the wrong recital, spirit shifting from life loving to homicidal, blinded by blood in their eyes that'll never die. But when a nigga kill a nigga too close to the one in his mirror, a nigga realize the genocide that he prescribed to. You mad because this proves the invisible truth that niggas spend their whole lives zoomed inside the belly of the beast that consumes them. And when the lifespan of black kids is cut too thin, niggas begin to believe their melanin is a sin and confide in bleached Bibles until brainwashed by slavery's newest cycle. You mad? Cause it's foolish. Psycho, homicidal nigga believe the only way to find God is committing suicide, so he proves it. Next Sunday revival, they pull his body from the pool behind the pulpit. Why are you so mad? Why are you so mad, huh? Huh? Our revolution ain't coming till you cut your bullshit. Get up and do shit.
Come on. Amen. Yeah.